त्वन्मुक्तिप्रदं देवं क्षमापूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वन्दे परमहंसाख्यं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतं शिवं मुक्तिप्रदं देवं क्षमापूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वन्दे परमहंसाख्यं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतं आनन्दानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वन्दे पापविनाशकं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतम् आनन्दानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वन्दे पापविनाशकं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तं निर्विकल्पं ध्यानलोकप्रदीपकं
परमहंस नित्यानन्दरु ನಮ್ಮ ಯುಗದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಅಭೂತಪೂರ್ವ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಶಕ್ತಿ. ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಮಾಜದ ಆಂದೋಲನದ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾಪಕರು, ಆಧುನಿಕ ವೈದಿಕ ನವೋದಯದ ಪ್ರಥಮ ಅನ್ವೇಷಕ, ಪವಿತ್ರ ಊರಾದ ತಿರುವಣ್ಣಾಮಲೈನಲ್ಲಿ ಜನ್ಮ ತಾಳಿದ ಒಬ್ಬ ಯೋಗಿ, ಕೆಚ್ಚೆದೆಯ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಸಂಶೋಧಕ, ದೈವ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶಕ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಇಂದು ಪ್ರಾಚೀನ ರಹಸ್ಯಾರ್ಥ ಯೋಗ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಪಥದಲ್ಲಿರುವ ಲಕ್ಷಾಂತರ ನಿಪುಣರಿಗೆ ಸ್ಫೂರ್ತಿದಾಯಕರಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕತೆಯ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನದ ಸಂಶೋಧನಾಕಾರ, ಆತ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ಕಾರ ತೋರುವ ಗುರುಗಳು, ಅವರ ವಿವೇಕದ ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಅವರ ನಗುವಿನ ಆ ಸಂತಸ ಹಾಗೂ ಅವರ ಅದ್ವಿತೀಯ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿ ವರ್ಷ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಪ್ರಪಂಚದಾದ್ಯಂತ ಸುಮಾರು 1 ಕೋಟಿ ಜನರೊಡನೆ ಹಂಚಿಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಈಗ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಜೀವನ್ಮುಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ, ಆನಂದಮಯ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಪರಿಹಾರಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಮರೆಯಲಾರದ ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಅನುಭವವನ್ನು ಕೈಗೊಳ್ಳೋಣ, ಬನ್ನಿ.
ಸರ್ವಧರ್ಮ ಪ್ರಣೇತಾರಂ ಸಚ್ಚಿದಾನಂದ ರೂಪಿಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಸನಾತನಂ ಪುಣ್ಯಂ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದಾಯ ಸ್ವಾಗತಂ ವೇದ ವೇದಾಂತ ಸಂವೇದ್ಯಂ.
There is a part of you which goes on changing. For example, at the age of 7, who were you? You are not the same at the age of 20. You are not the same at the age of 50. The part which is changing is continuously dying. You don't need to worry about that. The part which does not change will never die. It is there forever. It is going to be there forever. You assume yourself as mixture of both. There is part of you which never dies, and that is real you. But you have freedom to associate yourself with the part which dies also and suffer, no problem. See, there is some utility for you, immediate utility for you, when you associate yourself with the part which changes. Life looks more colorful. You can taste rasagulla, you can taste green chilli, you can have little fight. You can have little so-called love. You can play with all these games. You also entered into this play only like a casual choice. It is not that you are interested in getting bound and suffering with these 5 senses and being tortured. No, you just forgot it is the play you started in between the play. Nothing else. My association with the perishable part of me is casual, non-serious, not a committed relationship, a casual flow. In your life, it is so unfortunate. Your relationship with your perishable parts, the perishable dimension, has become serious commitment. The perishable cannot bring suffering for you. Don't take your relationship with perishable objects as a serious commitment. It is not committed relationship, it is a casual. There is some part of you which does not perish. Any action you do, ఎనీ డెసిషన్ యూ మేక్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దిస్ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ ద పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ మీ ఈస్ నాన్ పెరిషబుల్ ఈస్ తపస్. ద మోర్ అండ్ మోర్ తపస్, మోర్ అండ్ మోర్ ఎక్స్పాన్షన్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ ఎగ్జిస్టెన్స్, మోర్ అండ్ మోర్ యు ఆర్ ఎక్స్పాండింగ్. ఈవెన్ వైల్ యువర్ బాడీ ఈస్ కిల్డ్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ గెట్ కిల్డ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ బార్న్ నార్ డస్ ఇట్ డై. దెన్ కృష్ణ సేస్, ఏ యూ డోంట్ గెట్ కిల్డ్, దెర్ వాస్ నెవర్ అ టైమ్ ఐ నెవర్ ఎగ్జిస్టెడ్ ఆర్ యూ నెవర్ ఎగ్జిస్టెడ్, దెర్ విల్ నెవర్ బి అ టైమ్ బోత్ ఆఫ్ అస్ ఆర్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు బి ఎగ్జిస్టింగ్, కీప్ క్వైట్ అండ్ ఫైట్. మీన్స్ వాట్? ఈస్ డైరెక్ట్లీ గివింగ్ యూ ద ఇనిషియేషన్. Even if you don't realize that now, don't worry, I am doing what needs to be done, go ahead. He is initiating, giving assurance. All your suffering that you have not become enlightened also is useless. All your suffering because of your enlightened, non-enlightenment. Please understand, there is a two thing. Because you are not enlightened, out of your ignorance, you do some foolish things. Only those things are dangerous. But if you have the intense yearning and suffering that you are not enlightened, that is useless, that is not a big thing. That is no need for that. Just one assurance from a master can remove that. Krishna is first removing that suffering. Even if you think you are not enlightened, don't bother. When this whole body is useless for you, all the engrams which are obstructing you from enlightenment, they will also become useless. That time, I can just take all these things out and give you the enlightenment. See, it's like you got a new dress and you are telling the child, hey, this is the enlightenment dress, wear this. But the child is too attached to the dress it is wearing. He says, no, I am not enlightened. I don't want all that. I am not having it. Then you say, all right, it's okay. After 2 days, naturally, that dress will become dirty and old. You will throw it away. That time I will give you my new dress. You will wear. That's it. Same way when I say you are not the body, you are beyond body, you are Atman, you say no. Such a beautiful young body. What do you mean? I am not this. No, I am this only. Then I will tell, all right, naturally at one point it will become old and useless. That time I will tell you the same thing. Throw it away and come, that's all. It is just a business decision.
ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಎಂದರೇನು? ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯನಲ್ಲೂ ಸುಪ್ತವಾಗಿ ಅಡಗಿರುವ ಅಸಾಧಾರಣ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯವೇ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಗುರುಗಳ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಯಿಂದ ಈ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಳಿಸಬಹುದು. ಒಮ್ಮೆ ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಜಾಗೃತಗೊಂಡರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನದ ಪ್ರತಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳಲ್ಲೂ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ತರುವ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಅದಕ್ಕಿದೆ. ಹಾಗೂ ಅದು ನಿಮಗೆ ಆರೋಗ್ಯ, ಸಂಪತ್ತು, ಯಶಸ್ಸು, ಸಂತೋಷ ಭರಿತ ಸಂಬಂಧಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮಿಕ ಜ್ಞಾನೋದಯವನ್ನು ತಂದುಕೊಡುತ್ತದೆ. ಧ್ಯಾನ ಹಾಗೂ ದೀಕ್ಷೆಗಳ ಶಕ್ತಿಯ ಬಳಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕಂಡುಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಕುಂಡಲಿನಿ ಜಾಗೃತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಇಳುಕು ನೋಟವನ್ನು ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಅನುಭವಿಸಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭವಿಷ್ಯವನ್ನು ರೂಪಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಪ್ರತಿ ವಾರಾಂತ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಥಳ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಧ್ಯಾನಪೀಠ, ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ನಗರ, ಬಿಡದಿ, ಬೆಂಗಳೂರು.
The other day one devotee was sitting with me and talking. He was telling that he is doing a biodiesel business. I said, it was a failure, how are you doing it? He said, no Swamiji, at that time it was a failure. That time the mineral diesel was cheaper, biodiesel was costly. Now the mineral diesel price has gone so high, biodiesel has become cheap. Now it is successful. I thought, oh God, exactly when a body is young, youthful, it is more costlier than Atma, than your soul. Then you say, no, I am the body, I am this, I am that. Come on, let's paint, decorate, dress up. I have to do this, I have to do that. I can wait, no problem, till the mineral diesel price goes up and when biodiesel becomes cheap. So naturally at one point, body will become a big headache for you, suffering, torture. Then I will tell that, hey, you understand now? Come on, throw it away, put the new dress. This is the truth. This is what exactly Krishna is saying when he says, hey, it does not burn, nor does it die. It's not that having been non-existent, it comes into existence. It is unborn, eternal, ancient, everlasting. If you don't understand, it's okay, don't bother. By initiating this, I am giving you the guarantee. When the business decision changes a little bit, nothing. One small arrow, if it hits Arjuna in the right place, that is enough. His whole business will get imbalanced. Then at that moment, if Krishna says, hey, you are not the body, it is useless, you are beyond body, come on. Simply Arjuna's whole consciousness will go behind it. This is the whole secret of Antima Sannyasa. See, Antima Sannyasa means giving enlightenment in the last moment. This is the way. Boon or initiation or a teaching by an incarnation is not just a word, it is an assurance also for future. But the sufferings you create by your decisions and actions out of ignorance, that nothing can be done. That is going to be real. I think Krishna is in his best. I can tell you from my experience, when I'll be in my best, when some devotee comes and asks me something impossible, it's like somebody is having a cancer, doctor is saying nothing can be done, only few days the person will be alive, and his marriage is about to break, his last check is bouncing, he is completely depressed and doesn't know what to do. This kind of person comes to me and says, with tremendous confidence in his eyes, I think you can get me out of this whole mess. I have seen always, that is the moment I am in my best. I can see, there's a beautiful example. When a cow sees the calf, its child, automatically the milk starts happening in every pore of the cow. When a mother sees the child, for example, somebody has stolen the child, kidnapped the child, after a week or 10 days, somehow mother gets to get the child back, how she will rush and hug the child, her whole body will produce the milk to feed the child. Exactly at that same moment, you see, the mother, she is in her peak at that moment. I have seen exactly when a disciple asks me, when a devotee asks me that kind of a boons, which is simply impossible, I see every pore of me responding to it. Sometimes they will be very adamant. Do something now. I want to get rid of all this now, this moment. It will look very arrogant from outside. Even I will not be answering or responding to their tone or tune. But I tell you, that is the moment exactly I feel I am at my best. I see the energy gushing from me, out of me. Every pore in me expresses itself like a mother whose body is releasing milk to feed the child. Only when the person asks me with a confidence, I can do it. I have seen, it's like something happens in me. The village, farmers, people who milk the cows, they will use the certain oil they will apply on the cow's skin, castor oil, they will apply. Immediately cow will feel like releasing the milk. The milk will start flowing. Same way, with a confidence, when a devotee or disciple asks some boon, that Swamiji can do it. Suddenly I feel my whole body feels like an intense energy release. I am in my best.
ಓರ್ವ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷರಿಂದ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಜೀವನಕ್ಕೆ ದಿವ್ಯ ಮಾರ್ಗದರ್ಶನ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಬೇಕೇನು? ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತಪಡಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಪರಮಹಂಸರೊಡನೆ ಮುಖಾಮುಖಿ. ಇಡೀ ಜಗತ್ತಿಗೆ ಪರಮಹಂಸ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದರು ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ಅಪೂರ್ವವಾದ ಹಾಗೂ ಅಸದೃಶವಾದ ಉಡುಗೊರೆಯನ್ನು ನೀಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
Got practically everything and too much for a phone call.
ಪ್ರತಿದಿನ ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ ನಡೆಯುವ ಸತ್ಸಂಗದ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳಿಗೂ ನೇರವಾಗಿ ಉತ್ತರ ನೀಡಲು ಅವರು ಲಭ್ಯವಿರುವರು.
Now you ask anything you want in your life. Ask me any boon you want.
ಬೆಳಿಗ್ಗೆ 8 ಗಂಟೆಯ ನಂತರ +9180272799999 ಗೆ ಕರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಸ್ವಾಮೀಜಿಯವರೊಂದಿಗೆ ಮಾತನಾಡುವ ಅದೃಷ್ಟ ನಿಮ್ಮದಾಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಹಾಗೂ ntv.nityananda.org ಇದರ ನೇರ ಪ್ರಸಾರವನ್ನು ವೀಕ್ಷಿಸಿ.
I am at my best. I can say Krishna is in his best. Otherwise, no man will have courage or guts to reveal such a sacred secret, such a great truth. Krishna has kidnapped a girl for Arjuna and got her married to Arjuna. And Arjuna has done all possible things to get girls for Krishna. This kind of a relationship. And suddenly, one friend is telling the other friend, hey, even when your body gets killed, the Atman does not get killed, don't worry. Right, to utter this word to your friend who knows completely all about you, it needs kind of a certain sacred platform. I think Krishna got the confidence that there is a sacred platform by the Arjuna's devotion and dedication, the way Arjuna is listening. Otherwise, Arjuna would have told directly Krishna, hey, I know what all cunning play you do in your life and how many fellows you cheated in how many ways. And don't play with all these games with me. It's my life and death question. Leave me, Baba, I am running. Arjuna could have done that. Because Arjuna knows all the things Krishna does. And Arjuna could have told Krishna, hey, you yourself ran away from the war when you felt you can't handle. Actually, Krishna ran away once. So Arjuna could have told, hey, don't play all this game. Don't talk all these big, big things. I know when you ran away. He knows. But beyond all the actions of Krishna, certain click has happened for Arjuna with Krishna. I tell you, the unbroken Guru Bhakti can happen only when you start looking at me beyond all my actions. Please understand, I do not do any action. Now I am saying, I am not talking to you. If it clicks with you, your devotion can never be shaken. None of my action can be understood by you because I am not acting. I have no action. See, action needs certain components. Will, ambition, energy, and execution. Whatever you see as action in me, 99% of those components are missing. Then how will you call this as action? All the components for action is missing. See, for example, if you are sitting and talking like me, you will have an ambition, you will have a reason, you will have an action plan, you will execute something, something will not be executed. There will be so-called success or a failure. But in my action, almost all these components are missing. But when you perceive I am doing this action, you will perceive your purpose, your ambition, your reasons for your action. You will attribute all that to me. It is so unfortunate that people impose their ambition and reason and logic behind their actions to my actions, which does not have all that. Only when you click with the master beyond his actions, you are safe forever. Fortunately, that click has happened for Arjuna. I tell you, to live with a disciple with whom that click has happened is a heaven for an incarnation. Incarnation decide to live on planet Earth for a longer period when they see at least few disciples for whom the click has happened beyond the action of an incarnation. If you realize, if you understand, my actions do not have the ambition, reason, logic which you usually have it when you do the same action, is not there in my action. When this clicks with you, your devotion becomes unshakable. People many times ask me, what can I add to you, Swamiji? What more you can have? Nothing more can be added to you. But I tell you, if you want to add joy to me, you can do it in this way. Connecting with me beyond my actions. Then I tell you honestly, really you add joy to me. I love to spend time with people. I love to sit with people. I love to teach people. I love to talk to people who connect with me beyond my action, who understand the logic behind my action is not the logic behind your actions. It can't even be perceived by the logic behind your actions. So whatever you perceive as happening through me can't even be called as actions. I tell you, this connection has happened between Arjuna and Krishna. Krishna is in his peak. He is enjoying. Krishna and Arjuna, only few days gap. Arjuna is younger to Krishna, just few days. Not even a month. Less than a month. So almost 33 year relationship. They grew up together. But how is Arjuna able to receive? And Krishna is also able to tell. He says, it is not born, nor does it die. It is not that having been non-existent, it comes into existence. It's unborn, eternal, ancient, everlasting. Though associated with the body, it does not get killed even when the body is killed. See, you may say, no. Maybe for an enlightened being, the soul does not die. But for an ordinary person, it may be dying. No. Even though it is associated with the body, it does not get killed when the body is killed. You don't need a strong connection with a listener. But to tell this kind of honest, highest truths, you need a strong relationship with the listener. Not only he needs to trust you, and you need to trust that he trusts you. The trust has to have a complete cycle, circle. See, there is unique way you need to use to understand Master's words. It is unborn, eternal, ancient and everlasting. Just take the literal meaning. Now there will be a lot of questions in your mind. You became the person who is going to answer all those questions. That is where the game is going to be successful. If you put all your energy to prove these words are untrue by questioning, you are on the wrong side. You are a poker, not a seeker. Now you assume the responsibility, put all your energy to answer all the questions which you will be having about this truth. This is the way to listen to an enlightened master's teachings. Are you going to play the societal side of you or the guru side of you? In you there are two parts. One is your buddhi, guru side of you. Another one is buddhihina, the societal side of you. If you are going to put your energy on your societal side and create more and more and more and more stronger and stronger idiotic, foolish doubts and questions, you can be playing that side, no doubt, no problem. But if you are going to put all your energy and interest and intensity to this side, the side of your buddhi, and you are going to be sitting and answering, that's the way to listen to the truths from the master.
It has 2000 crore loss. have decided that I myself going personally sitting in Pondicherry and going to do the relief work.
Expected to reach at least 1 lakh people per day.